why do you like him then?
No, first of all, the best guitar playing imaginable is Steve Vai, and then the superb, divine bass meistership by Billy.
And I'm really happy to see Steve Vai alive in the Ultra World.
What about you, sir?
Yeah, he's a marvellous instrumentalist. One of the best in the world. He's great. He's absolutely off this planet.
And we came all the way from Nepal to the concert.
You guys serious?
Yeah.
He's definitely a composer and arranger. I think that's the main thing, isn't it? Amazing.
He's probably the best guitarist in the world for the last 20 years or something. That's enough, isn't it?
You can't say any better than that.
Play whatever you want, pull it off. But he's a good artist for inspiration. Like, gives you ideas, you can see how far you can pull it and then take it.
You guys play too fast, but every note, every single note in each of his films really carries such passion. And it just floors me. I've come here tonight to hear him play together with Billy Sheehan because that I've been waiting 10 years for that to happen.
Now, Stevie, I don't want to listen, okay? I'm going to go in and I'm going to introduce you, and then you're going to come in with your guitar, and you're going to play that nice, nice music you were telling me about. And while you're doing that, I'll be sitting in the back of the room. We'll have such a good time, so don't you be nervous, honey. It'll relax everybody, and we'll be so happy. I'm going to go now. I'll introduce you, okay? Okay, everyone in your own seats, that's good. Okay, now little Stevie Vai is going to play a composition on the guitar. He wrote it all by himself. Okay, Stevie, bring your three friends up, they can play with you. That's Steve Vai. What a nice little boy.
Personality, stop the movement!
once again, what a great, great privilege and an honor it is to come to this beautiful city and play, and to see you here. Thank you. Because you know, it seems like right now, more than any other time, is the best time to celebrate music. You know what I'm talking about? And we know that there's a lot of unfortunate things going on in the world right now. But when we come together here, when we come together to celebrate music, we leave the world outside. We come together here, any color, any nationality, any race, any religion, and we celebrate music as a family, right? That's what I like. Well, let me introduce you to some of your family, okay? We have Dave Weiner on guitar. You know, Dave lived here for a year when he went to school. He's got a lot of friends in the audience tonight. His mom and dad are here, so be good to him tonight, all right? See, that's just like Elvis. All right, we got Virgil Donati on drums. You better be careful, later on he's gonna kick your ass. Listen, it gives me great pleasure to have a tremendous musician in this band tonight, Tony MacAlpine. Later on, he might kick my ass. Ooh. Okay, let me see if we got Tony. Dave. Ah. What? What? In case you haven't noticed, see this guy standing right here with that funny little thing in his hand? See that guy over there with that funny little thing in his hand? See that guy there? See that guy up there? We are making a DVD tonight. So feel free at any time to let the rest of the world know what London is like, all right? Starts like this! We'll be right back. First time in a video. All right, this next song is a ballad that I wrote. It's about peace and love and good happiness stuff.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back.
Welcome to the heavy metal section of the show.
Thank you.
record. The record is called Compression. This is called Chameleon. Enjoy. Actually, we can play a Britney Spears song if you like. Not really, because that's what we practice in our spare time. Come on now. No, actually, I like pop music. I'm a big pop music fan, really. No, there's some good stuff out there. No, really, come on. I could have been a pop star. Oh, really? I mean, can you imagine me being a pop star and everything? I don't know. Like, why would I want to be a pop star when I can go like this? Steady, cheers. I learned that from Britney. Actually, no, I'll have to tell you. Like I was saying, I actually like pop music occasionally. I mean, take Jimi Hendrix, for instance. I mean, he was like half pop star, half freak. I only got the freak end of it. Not like Billy, though. And not like Dave, of course, whose hormones are just going crazy. Poor guy's 20 years old and he's stuck in the Steve Vai band. Okay. Can you imagine, though, like if Jimi Hendrix was here and he had a sort of a little conversation with Britney? What do you think he'd say? Maybe let's watch MTV from the bottom of the sea. Oh-hoo. I think he would say something like, "You don't care for me, I don't care about that. You got a new fool, I like it like that. I've only want a burning desire. Let me stand next to you." to your fire. Stand next to your home fire. Song. Thank you.
circus man. There's no new why. Butterflies and zebras and moonbeams and a fairy tale. It's all she ever thinks about, you know. Riding with the wind. She said it's all right. You could take anything you want from me. You take anything, London. And I mean anything. Jimmy did write beautiful songs, didn't he? Alright, this next song is from my new record, Alive in an Ultra World. And I want to play it on flow, so Thomas has to tune the guitar, okay? And this song, you know, the last record was recorded all around the world, and some of it was actually recorded right here last time. That's right, this song is called Whispering a Prayer. Thank you.
Thank you.
few more songs. Oh, I love it when he just goes for it, you know? We'll be right back.
Yeah.
I knew I made the right choice by recording this gig. Hey! We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Steve Vai, come on. To tell you thank you is a feeble attempt to show my gratitude. Thank you so much. God bless you. We'll see you next time, okay? Good night.